the University of Montana Center for Translational Medicine is working on important vaccines for COVID-19, program we started earlier this year, as well as opioid addiction, influenza virus, tuberculosis, Pseudomonas, and other important indications such as immuno-oncology and allergy. So we started watching in December when the first reports came out about COVID. We started looking into previous outbreaks with SARS and MERS. And as early as February, we were discussing with partners and with NIH on how we could help. The vaccine research program we've assembled here at the University of Montana is on par with any vaccine research group in the country, including those at Oxford or Harvard or some other schools that are maybe more known for the research capabilities. But the team of 45 people we have here is by far a world-class vaccine research team.
I didn't think that our lab would be considered one of the top labs to like work on this project in the United States, and that we're a pivotal part of the country when it comes to finding a cure and just expanding the general knowledge of the virus to help anybody who would be able to figure out like a really effective vaccine.
University science has always been critical to advancements in all kinds of different medical and other types of technologies. Right now, it's more critical than ever with things like COVID, the opioid epidemic, and things like that going on. University research like the lab right here at University of Montana are making breakthroughs that will drive the next generations of medicines moving into the clinic for helping people.
And a lot of research that can happen is purely academic and would take a really long time before anything real came to the public. And he has the ability to be that bridge between academia and manufacturing and being able to actually get life-saving medicines to people.
The things that give me hope is if you had asked me, 9 months ago how long it would take to develop a COVID vaccine, I would have told you at a minimum 5 years. And we're hearing that it might be done in a year or less. We've seen some dramatic changes in the way that regulatory agencies like the FDA work with universities and work with companies to rapidly accelerate the vaccine development process. And that's not making a vaccine that's less safe. It's just speeding up the process to get there.
Being a part of a lab in Montana, which a lot of people don't really think about Montana as being a great vaccine candidate, but then that article came out about us being in the top 10, so it's pretty cool to be able to be a part of something like that, and it definitely makes me feel a little bit at ease to know that this is not only going on here at UM, but also across the whole world.
A lot of people have come together to make this work. Hopefully what we'll learn from this will continue to advance drug discovery and vaccine development for years to come, ways to work together and different ways of working together and doing things better and more efficiently.
I think that we will find a vaccine. I think that even if the first one that comes out isn't that effective, we'll eventually get one that's extremely effective to end the pandemic. And I think what gives me the most calmness is that I get to come in every day and work on it and actually work on the problem, when I feel very lucky that I get to do that.
I am, like most people that live in Montana, when I'm not at work, I'm usually in the outdoors. I learned to fish before I could walk. So it's always been a passion of mine. I grew up in a family that was big into the outdoors. And so I maintain that, and now I enjoy doing it with my kids as well. I've learned a lot from fishing through science. I mean, as a scientist, I'm very analytical. So now when I come out on the water, I think about, what kind of hatch is going on if I'm fly fishing, the current weather patterns, the water color, what the weather's been doing lately. You put all those things together, it's kind of like putting an experiment together. If you get the right things in the right order, it seems to always work.